Do you have to wait a very long time before the 3D printer starts printing? I'll explain how to improve your 3D printing startup times. Coming up! Welcome to my YouTube channel Green-Eyed Explorer, where I explore further and beyond about tweaks, hacks, electronics and house repairs. On my original Velamen K8200 3D printer, the power supply is only 15 volts 6.6 amps, which gives us roughly 100 watts. As the nozzle heating block is very small, it gets to the desired temperature very quickly. The major problem here is heating up the bed. This applies to all printers. Mine is size of 20 by 20 centimeters. With its resistance of 6 ohms, it means it consumes 37.5 watts of power. As you have figured out, the heated bed is the bottleneck of fast starting up the prints. Let's dive into the solution. So we want our heated beds to consume more power to heat up faster. In short, we have to install a more powerful supply. Higher voltage, higher current. For the enthusiasts, I prepared short calculations. You can skip them directly to the connection part. As you know, voltage multiplied by current gives us power. If you want to increase the power, you have to deliver more voltage or current. Analogy: you cannot force the water to flow faster through the canyon if there is not enough additional force to push it through. That is what Ohm's law tells us about electricity. You know that at certain voltage the current is limited by the resistance. So we will have to increase the voltage. Let's see the original situation and upcoming one. 15 volts, in my case, divided by 6 ohms gives us 2.5 amps. So the power will be 15 multiplied by 2.5. This makes 37.5 watts. Or you can calculate the power from the equation 4 on the screen. If we use 24 volt power supply, the case is 24 volts divided by 6 ohms gives 4 amps. So 24 multiplied by 4 makes 96 watts. This would give us roughly 2.5 times gain. Nice! Connection. Almost all 3D printer electronics use MOSFETs to drive the heating. If we want to connect higher voltage power supply and do not want to interfere with original electronics, I suggest you use a DC-DC solid state relay between the printer electronics and heated bed. Find the links below for the needed parts. We will connect printer electronics to SSR via a small resistor of about 12 kilo ohms. At 15 volts on the original PCB, this gives us 15 milliwatts of power loss on the printer side, which is negligible. Then we connect our 24 volt power supply on the other side and to the bed. Simple steps and no intervention into printer's electronics. I chose an AC-DC converter from Geek Crate, which is very small and fits nicely alongside the solid state relay. See the link below for more. I fitted them in a small printed enclosure and fastened it to the printer. Results. With a stock power supply, when I wanted to print ABS filament, which requires 210 degrees Celsius hot bed, I had to wait 3/4 of an hour to 1 hour to start the printing. Not to mention, if I opened the window to get rid of the ABS smell, the bed temperature dropped and it caused my prints to get ruined. By upgrading the bed power supply with the 24 volt one, prints start in about 10 to 15 minutes. Estimated cost with costume printed ABS box were around 20 euros. An investment worthwhile. Don't forget to hit like below, comment what you think of this upgrade or have better ideas, share this video with your friends and consider subscribing to my channel. Watch my other videos on 3D printing. Thank you for sticking by, see you next time!